I've got some shit I gotta get off my chest, man. I've been sitting here being quiet for a long time, man.
Yeah.
We are a lot of motherfuckers been talking a lot of shit.
Wrong man,
don't know shit. Far be it from me, but I'm gonna have to break shit down real fucking simple for you.
Who else is gonna do it?
I brought that genuine shit in 96. Before you knew the underground or independent exists, I watched the whole scene straight jump on a dick. After stepping a KTR lit and flexing my shit. No gun talk, no gimmicks, just rounds of raw dog. Dirty, dusty, intelligent wit and word murdering. The hardcore poetic that's formed without burglary. Potent and shook the shit out of rappers who just learned to me. Every time I prescribe a new pill, revolution. Quickly define a standard for indie rap distribution. Arrogant, unafraid shit, developed right in the train, thinking of brain fuck. Bad touch example that soon became bucks. Had everybody sprung, wondering where I came from. Screaming out independent as fuck with an insane tongue. With an indelible squad of design monsters. Innovating with styles that made biters look like imposters. So we scripted an album and signed a raucous. Selling 100,000 without a radio chart hit. Preposterous sonics taking the world hostage. Classic hip hop homage, dirty with style progress. Now I'm come from the 80s juvenile Brooklyn. Cats
give me
life,
that
subway pass kid, good looking. Now someone else taking a ride with what's mine. So I had to develop styles with a death device cooked in. So when I battled in basements, I had 8 sentences waiting, ready for the 4 you had laced in. And I was taught to be patient.
Why?
Only faggots switch they shit up just to get famous. So when I finally blew up, I remained sick, earning respect in ghettos and birds for word placement. Back when the independent scene remained faceless, we were the only crew who promised your ass we'd take it. Mold it, shape it, living outside the matrix. Hold it, make it, more than miniature major labels. Hold it sacred, living it for the culture. Told you plainly, protected it from the vultures. That's why I always get respect from true soldiers and laugh at the critics claiming every year
hip-hop's over.
Fuck you, hip-hop just started. It's funny how the most nostalgic cats are the ones who were never part of it. But true veterans will give dap to those who started it, then humbly move the fuck on and come with that new retarded shit. New slang, new thought, new sound, new heart. You thought, you hang, you clown, you don't, you drown. I won't dumb it down, I'm dumbing out with these rounds. I'm a live motherfucker, plus I'm gunning for clowns. You're a mind motherfucker, don't be coming for pounds. So you can break out of that invisible box, you're not down. My favorite ones are the ones who started out young, rap about comic books, spaceships, and Obi-Wan 1. And even though they were soft, they had fun, but they couldn't break out the frame of the town they came from. Some of these faggots used to send me the demos, keeping their puppy styles in the company flow kennels. But since they had no identity from the start, they started to resent the scene when they couldn't become a part. They've been failing for years and call themselves vets, that's bold. Motherfucker, you're not a vet, you're just old. I slapped the shit out you to continue my nerd rap, making his money fist over fist, fuck what you heard. Rookie cats talking about boom bap and golden ages, pat themselves on the back for making that new outdated shit. But I've been putting out vinyl since 93 and never looked back once at y'all trying to chase me. You don't innovate because you can't innovate, it's not a choice, despite what you might tell your boys. Keep your identity crisis under the table, I always knew who I was and I'll always be more famous.